President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has appointed former Chief Justice Lucas Bersamin as his new executive secretary. Bersamin took his oath before Marcos today. The palace says he began his duties immediately by attending the 9th cabinet meeting. Bersamin replaces Marcos's longtime lawyer and spokesman Vic Rodriguez, who resigned this month. Bersamin most recently headed government-owned insurance system GSIS. He was appointed to that post by former President Rodrigo Duterte back in 2020 after he retired as the country's top magistrate. The death toll from Typhoon Karding rises to 9. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council has recorded 2 casualties in Zambales province, one in Quezon and another in Bataan, on top of the 5 rescuers who died in Bulacan. The NDRRMC also observed significant agricultural losses, while damage to infrastructure was minimal.
Ang agriculture natin ang suffered most from this typhoon. 160 million worth of damage to agriculture has been reported by our department department concerned, and close to 3,780 affected farmers and fisher folks.
11,000 families across Luzon were also forced to evacuate, but many have returned to their homes. The province of Nueva Ecija declares a state of calamity due to widespread destruction caused by Typhoon Karding. Hundreds of families remain in evacuation centers as local authorities continue clearing operations. Classes in all levels remain suspended. The largest damage in the province is in agriculture, with Nueva Ecija serving as the rice granary of Central Luzon.
Malungkot po yan. Dahil sa yung anin, konti na lang. Unabis na marami, kumonte. Eh, mapalad pa po tayo kaysa sa ibang lugar.
Kaya po sana kung sino po yung may mabuting loob, yung sa ating Pangulo, nais ko rin po humingi ng tulong sa kanya, hindi lang po para sa akin, kundi para na rin sa lahat ng nasalanta.
The local government of Polillo Island in Quezon Province mulling to declare a state of calamity in the aftermath of Typhoon Karding. Mayor Angelique Bosque says they're assessing the full extent of the damage left by the storm. So far, there are no reported casualties in the area, but the storm destroyed homes and left massive damage to agriculture. Mayor Bosque also appealing for immediate assistance from the national government.
Bagyo sa LGU po namin, hindi po namin masabi. Ito po ay pang, siguro po pang ilang araw lang dahil madami din po talaga yung affected families dito po sa amin. 5 pa lang po na barangay ang kanila po naibalik ang power. Regarding po dun sa ibang barangay, ongoing po yung clearing and assessment nila dahil meron nga po mga sanga ng puno na sumabit po sa power line. Dun po sa palay po, sa sakahan po ng palay, out of 450 plus hectares, nasa 50% na po yung damaged crop. Yun sa mga bananas naman po ay 100% po. And then sa fisheries po, medyo malaki din po yung damage.
Karding made landfall over Polillo Island Sunday as a super typhoon. Karding also left thousands of families homeless in the province of Aurora. The municipality of Dingalan says over 6,000 houses were damaged. The provincial government plans to help typhoon survivors through a cash for work program.
Yung mga nasiraan ng bahay ay tatrabahuhin ko nila, ayusin nila yung bahay nila. We will provide materials and then meron pang compensation po dun sa kanila.
Initial damage to agriculture in the province is pegged at 51 million pesos. Local officials say Karding is far worse than Typhoon Ulysses, which also hit the province in 2020. But the town mayor is still grateful that no life was lost.
Dahil taon-taon naman po ay talagang dinadalaw ng bagyo itong aming lugar at isa pong paniniwala na ang pagiging handa talaga pong magiging maganda po ang resulta na maiwasan po ang pagkasawi o pagkawala ng isang buhay.